A new era of spaceflight has started thanks to billionaires funding their own space agencies. But as we look to escape Earth, there's a man-made issue that may keep us trapped on our world. It's already threatened the integrity of the International Space Station and any ship looking to leave. What exactly is this threat? Trash.
My God, there's just so much garbage.
Endless fields of space junk circling the Earth at 5 miles per second, nearly 7 times faster than a bullet. Something seemingly as harmless as a paint chip is now a potentially devastating hazard. Of course, this trash heap in the sky also affects those of us stuck on Earth. Welcome back to Technality. I'm Jacqueline Swan, and I'm looking for a few friends to join me in cleaning up the sky. Not really, but I do think it's important that we address the space junk problem that we've created for ourselves. What exactly is space junk, and why is there so much of it? Space junk is any piece of machinery or debris left behind by humans. It could be as big as a defunct satellite or piece from a rocket to something as small as a glove lost by an astronaut on a spacewalk. There are approximately 34,000 pieces of space junk bigger than 10 centimeters in size, with millions of smaller pieces that could be disastrous if they crash into something else, like the International Space Station or one of the 2,000 active satellites orbiting Earth. Essentially, there is a graveyard of whizzing debris in Earth's lower orbit that humans have left behind. And like the trash heaps on the ground, it's starting to become worrying. At the speed these pieces are traveling, regardless of their size, they could puncture a hole in the International Space Station, risking the lives of everyone on board. And space junk has already left its mark on the moon. Just on March 4th, 2022, a booster believed to be from China's CHANG 521 lunar mission crashed into the moon, leaving behind a new crater. While this doesn't really affect Earth, it does raise questions about the proliferation of space junk. To prevent any crises, space agencies actually keep an eye on any object headed toward the ISS that's over 10 centimeters. The station can course correct to prevent any collisions, but they have to do more of that every year. That's also not to mention that they've had to cancel several spacewalks. But why does this affect us on Earth, those without the funds to space travel? Well, for a few reasons, unfortunately. Companies like Starlink and OneWeb launching satellite constellations on top of testing out rockets for space travel and other satellites, Earth's lower orbit is going to see a lot more debris added. For some researchers, they worry that the proliferation of space junk will lead to issues with telescopes. They believe that if there's too much debris, it will start to reflect the sun's rays, messing with the scientists' ability to view deep space. There's also the risk of debris colliding into satellites, which will create more debris. And all of this junk has different directions and states of decay, so tracking every individual piece is impossible. One of the worst case scenarios is Kessler syndrome. The theory refers to the effect of colliding debris cascading out and causing additional collisions. This in turn would cause the pieces to collide and destroy other satellites. As more and more junk is added, the chance of a self-sustaining collision that eventually breaks down everything in orbit to small pieces grows. Eventually, it's theorized that Earth's lower orbit would be a collection of small, swift-moving pieces that would immediately bombard anything that enters the orbit. It would be a debris field shield that would essentially surround the entirety of the planet. If this happens, you can essentially say goodbye to anything that relies on these satellites, like your cell reception, internet, and the weather forecast. However, that's the worst case scenario. But Kessler's theory is starting to look more and more like reality as we continue to put more objects into orbit. But as I said before, there's potential that we could lose important satellites. And we really don't take note of how much we rely on this technology until it's too late. On May 20th, 1998, PanOmSat's Galaxy 4 satellite mysteriously stopped working, which resulted in some TV and radio signals getting knocked out. However, it also knocked out 90% of the world's pagers, which at the time was equivalent to losing your cell phone. People quickly realized how much they had come to rely on this technology in their daily lives. And while this story doesn't involve space junk, it does highlight the importance of satellites in our lives and why we can't risk losing this quite literal space. It's not that we need to stop launching satellites. We can't, honestly. It's more that agencies and governments need to be better at keeping that area clear. Because if we want to continue enjoying the benefits of satellites while also having the option to space travel, we can't risk trapping ourselves under a minefield of space trash. There are, of course, a few things that are being done to address all of this, though. International guidelines recommend that satellite operators remove spacecraft after 25 years. Of course, only 60% have done that, and it's not exactly at the front of mind for most governments to be enforcing. There's also some movement by companies and academic institutions to help with this problem. In 2018, a research group launched a satellite called Remove Debris. It would launch a net and drag the junk down so it would burn up in the atmosphere. There's also space vents, which when I first heard the term, I thought it was a fenced off area in the lower orbit that would keep the area clear of space junk. It's not. It's actually the most advanced radar system that tracks and monitors things in lower orbit. Compared to other systems, it does a better job of tracking smaller debris, allowing operators to better predict space events. And being able to predict potentially devastating collisions allows for better response times. And then we have the Woz himself, Steve Wozniak, and his latest venture. Teaming up with orbital mechanics professor Dr. Jha and business associate Alex Fielding, Steve Wozniak helped co-found Privateer. Privateer's mission is to clean up Earth's lower orbit. Really though, there's not a lot of movement to address this issue. But as companies turn their eyes to interstellar travel, we're probably going to start seeing a lot more innovation in terms of how we clean up Earth's lower orbit. But what do you think about this whole space junk issue? I would love to hear your thoughts in the comments section below. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a thumbs up. And for more content on how technology is affecting your future, subscribe to Technality.